Hi, welcome back to my channel. And in this video, as you can probably tell from the title, I'm coming back with another hair tutorial on this style here. This butterfly locks in the bob length. I wanted it really short because in my job, we have to wear our hair in a ponytail if it's past your shoulders. And I'm kind of tired of wearing a ponytail every day to work and a bun and all that stuff. So I just wanted to do a bob. It's the first time I ever did this and I love it. Let's get right into the tutorial. Okay, so as you can see, I'm back. It's looking a lot better than it did before. I went back and got more of the hair that I liked, which is this brand. I'm on the last two. I'm gonna show y'all how I was doing it. And some of them I was putting two in one, and some of them I was just doing one. And I was pretty much just grabbing. So I'm grabbing one from here, which is kind of random, and one from there. But the problem was I was gonna have too many locks, and I didn't want this to be so big, which is how it was coming out. And I was like, it doesn't matter because I'm about to get a retwist anyway. But then she told me to wait another 2 weeks. So I'm glad I didn't take this style out or nothing like that. All right, so I'm gonna show y'all how I did these real quick. I used two on each. And then I try to find it in the middle, you know, like where that little groove is. So that's the middle of that one. That's the middle of this one. Okay, I hold it like that. Then I just rake through the hair to make it puffy. Get my crochet hook, close the latch, put it through both of the locks. Wait, let me do that again. Put it through both of the locks like so. Make sure it's turned with the hook open and facing up. Then I put the hair and the hoop where the groove was, close it, and then pull it through, and I take it, pull one side through, and boom, that's all I do for that. Then I let one string hang, like I want it to be a little shorter. One side. I want one side to be shorter, like to be the length that I want it to stop. So around here. Then I get the other side. I rake through it again because it's kind of coming together. And I want it to be puffy. Because it'll cover more if it's puffy, it'll cover more of my lock. And it'll get it to the size that I need it to be. Okay, and then I wrap. I'm gonna keep kind of tight at the top. Because as y'all can see, I do need a retwist. But this is also gonna make sure that the hair doesn't unwrap. And it's also, I like doing it like this because my hair doesn't look too fresh. I don't really like that look. So, yeah. Just gonna wrap. If I get to the length that I want it to be, about right here is good. So I'm gonna hold it there and then I'm gonna start wrapping up like so. Start wrapping up the lock. And this hair is from the other side. I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna pull it and start wrapping it around. And this is where your locks get really big and you can start leaving out curls if you choose and all that stuff. I only really want the curls towards the end. And I like the top to be kind of neat. And I just keep wrapping random hairs, like all the little fuzzies. And then you just roll it in your hands a few times and boom, that's it. Now I have one more left on this side. I'm just doing the same thing. Got the two together. I'm holding it in the middle. I'm separating the curls. That I want. There is about it. I hold the lock in that piece of hair, the shorter piece. Separate this all the way through. Because remember, you didn't separate the part that went in the hook. So yeah, then I just wrap.